So now we're ready to finish the web crawler. And remember what we want the web crawler to do. So we have a seed page, and we're assuming we know some seed page to start with. And the seed page has some links on it. We want to be able to find those links, and we know how to do that now. We're going to get them a list, and then we're going to follow those links. So we'll follow the links to new pages. And those new pages might also have links, and we want to follow those links. So in order to do this, we need to think about two things. We need to keep track of all the pages that we're waiting to crawl, and we'll introduce a variable toCrawl to do that. And what toCrawl will be is a list of pages left to crawl. So initially, it'll just be the seed page. Once we collect the links on the seed page, well, it will include those links as well. Once we finish crawling a page, we don't want to keep it in toCrawl anymore. And as we find new pages to crawl, they'll be added to the toCrawl list. The other variable we want is to keep track of all the pages that we've crawled. At the end of our crawl, this is the result. We want to know all the pages that we found. That will be stored in the variable we'll call crawled. So let's walk through an example of how this should work on the sample site. So I'll make the seed page, www.udacity.com/cs101x/index.html. That's this page here. That means when we start the crawl, we want toCrawl to be this index page. And I'm going to stop writing out the full URLs, just writing out the final part, because all the pages we crawl will be on our test site. So toCrawl will be the list containing just one element, the index.html page. We haven't crawled anything yet. We're just getting started. So crawled will start out as the empty list. The next thing we're going to do is crawl this page. So we'll get all the links on this page. That means we've crawled the index page. So that will now be added to crawled. But when we looked at the links on the index page, we found three new links on that page. We found the link here, which goes to crawling.html. We found the link here, which goes to walking.html. And we found the link here that goes to flying.html. So the new value of toCrawl after crawling this page will have those three links in it. The next thing we want to do is take one of those links and crawl it. The order actually matters a lot in terms of getting a good crawl. Let's assume for now that we'll just do the last one first. So we'll do the link fly that links to the flying page. Here's the page there. So we're going to crawl the page flying.html. This page doesn't have any links. If you're not sure why squeamish ossifrage is the magic words, I would encourage you to DuckDuckGo or Google that. And now we've finished crawling flying. So that's going to be added to the crawled list, which already had index.html. We don't lose that. We're going to add the new one, which is flying, to that list. And we finished crawling it, so we don't want to crawl it again. Let's remove it from the toCrawl list. Now, after we've crawled flying, we have two more links left in our toCrawl list. We have two links that we've crawled. So let's try another link. Let's suppose we follow the crawling.html link, and we follow crawling, we get to this page. So to follow crawling, we're going to follow the same algorithm we did with flying, right? So that removes this link from the toCrawl list, adds it to the crawled list. So we're done crawling. And now we want to add to our toCrawl list all the links that we find on this page. Well, we found the link kicking, which goes to the page kicking.html. So we're going to add that to our list of pages to crawl. And now we keep going. And we're going to keep going. We'll follow kicking. We find that kicking does not have any links. So that would add kicking to the crawled list and remove it from the toCrawl list. And we're going to keep going until we have no more pages to crawl. So let me describe that process a little more formally, and then I'll ask you a question about it.